Hey guys, this next technique sample is designed to introduce you to the 3D pen tool. This is a great tool if you want to just design directly on your garment, just kind of draw your seam lines where you want. So for example, we're going to try to turn this outfit into something that is color blocked or just has more seaming details. So you could assume like this is your block fleece sweatshirt. And then just maybe some your block leggings, and we can add some seam lines to kind of style it up. So here is a 3D tool. It says 3D pen. You'll notice in parentheses it says garment. So this is designed to draw on fabric, okay? Right above it is the one with the little white arrow. So as always, that means it's the edit tool. So you'll start with your 3D pen tool. You'll draw some lines on your garment, and then if you want to go in and change them, you can use the edit tool as well. After you draw them, you'll have the option to turn them into an internal line, and once they're an internal line on your 2D pattern, there's so many more things you can do with it. You know, you can cut your pattern, you can like add elastic, add top stitching, add sew lines, like all kinds of stuff. So it's just kind of a cool way to mark up your pattern in the 3D window, because I think a lot of us are more visual when we see 3D garments. So it's just kind of, I think, a nice way to design. Now, some of you guys might notice underneath it, we have another tool that's also called 3D pen, but it says avatar. So this is different. This is designed to design directly on your avatar, not on a garment, not on like a block t-shirt, sweatshirt, leggings, or whatever. This is really good if you're really trying to get some contoured shapes to really fit the body. You would want to use that one. It's a little bit more complicated because you have to flatten out some of your seams. But we're not going to do that today. We're just going to focus on the 3D pen tool, have some fun, turn this thing into like a cool color block, sweatshirt, and some leggings. Okay. With that said, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to crop this guy to make it short. I found something on Lululemon I'm going to try to mimic, but I'm going to start by making the sweatshirt cropped and a little bit short. I should probably tell you, do you guys see that seam line? This pattern piece is linked. So because it's linked, it's going to be symmetrical. So I only need to draw on the front and the back. I don't need to draw on both. Where's right and left front? I only need to do one, and it's automatically going to copy the other one. So instead of me drawing a full circle around the whole garment as my crop line, I really only need to go from front to center back, and it'll just copy it. Because if I go all the way around, you're going to have like a double line, which is kind of weird. But it's good. It's handy because it's being symmetrical. So I'm just going to kind of eyeball where I want to start. I'll click one time, and there we go. I got my first point. You can see it's getting ready for my second point. Now I want to go straight, so I'm going to hold shift, and you can see a purple line kind of comes up just to show you what is parallel to the floor. I'm just clicking here and there, and it'll even cross the seam line, so I can go on to now my back pattern piece. Not like you have to stick with your front one. Let's say I accidentally make a mistake and I don't want that point. You don't have to start over by hitting escape. You can just hit backspace. My keyboard, it's delete, and it just undoes the last one. So that's handy if you're like really concentrating and you make one little mistake and you don't want to start from scratch. So I'm going to hold shift again. I'm going to click that guy. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to pan. So when you're done, all you have to do is double click. Click, click. So mine didn't really work, or maybe it did. I just have to wait. Be patient. Okay, give it a minute. Okay, cool. So I did it. There it is. It's yellow. Awesome. So now I can maybe go to the edit tool. If there's anything I want to change, I don't know. Excuse me. So now I'm just going to right click, and I have the option to actually cut it right away, or I can trace it as an internal line. I don't know. Maybe I'll try to cut. Let's see what happens. Oh, did it. Okay. So my pattern has been cut. So now I can just select and delete it. Delete. Let's go over here to the back side. Click and delete. And delete. Okay, cool. So there we go. We got a crop top here. I guess I'll hit spacebar just to kind of simulate it. Great. Okay, cool. Okay, so to kind of match my photograph, I'm going to have to make her waistband a little bit higher. So I guess it's probably easiest to go ahead and do that on the 2D pattern. So I'm just going to kind of scooch it out over here. And I'll hit the letter Z. Well, there's two things. I could just manually bring it up, or I can select the line. I can right click and I could say change length. So right now it's 2.6. What if I just make it an even 3? And I like how the arrow is pushing it up. So that's okay. That's good. Okay, it looks like I'll have to do the same on the other side. Oh, I messed up. Command Z. Do you guys see that? Did you see what I did wrong? I'm going to do it again. Change length. The arrow is going down. I want the arrow to go up. So I'm going to change it to end in this case. Type in 3. Now the arrow is going the right direction. Okay. Those are not linked, so I also have to do it on this one. Change length. Where's my arrow? Oop, going the wrong way. End. Three. And then same on this last one. Okay. Okay, so with the 3D pen tool, I'm gonna go ahead and grab that guy. And I guess I'll start at the side seam, which is a little tricky to see. But if I get it wrong, I can always clean it up later. Now, how do I do a curved line? Because the image I'm trying to copy is a little bit curved. So to do that, you want to hold Command if you're on a Mac. If you're on a PC, it's the button right next to your spacebar to the left. So I'm just going to hold that down and I click one time. You don't click or drag or anything. It just turns it into a curved line. So I'm just kind of holding that button to make my little curved lines. I'm going to right click. I'm going to come up here and I guess I'll just stop at the back right seam. I'm going to do a click, click, a little double click, and I should be done. Okay, there we go. Taking its time. Now, on this case, it did not copy to my linked pattern. Honestly, I don't really know why, but I'm not that stressed out about it because it's easy to copy it on over. So if you want to make any changes, you can, of course, with your edit tool right here. It's currently selected and I can see it on the 2D. I'm happy with it. You can always change it if you're not. But I'm going to right click it. I'm going to hover over the yellow line, right click. And then it does have the option to duplicate it to the symmetric pattern. So I'll just do that. And then let's see here. Okay. So actually another thing I can do is, I guess I can hold shift to select both of them and I can right click and I can say cut and sew because I want it sewn together as well. So there we go. So now it's gonna be a seam right there. Okay, cool. The other thing that's going on is like there's this little pocket that's happening. So a little patch pocket. So this time, instead of making a seam, I'm just gonna draw like a style line to turn into an internal line. Let's see here. I wonder if there's a better way I can view my fabric. I'm going to play with this toggle menu so you can kind of see the lines a little bit better. Not the best. Anyways, okay, I'll just stick with that for right now. Okay, so back to my 3D, the regular tool. Oh, it went away. Fine. Who cares? Okay, I'm going to click here one time and just wherever you want that pocket to go, I guess right here, I'm going to click, click. Okay, and then what I want to do is, I think I just want it on one side, so I'm not going to put it on both. And I'm just going to go ahead and say convert to an internal shape. Okay, here we go. Okay, so it looks like I did not quite cross the outer pattern lines. So I'm going to want to right click this guy and say extend and trim and add point to my pattern outline. There we go. So now it goes across my entire pattern. And then now I can use the tracing tool right here. It kind of looks like a little patch pocket. And I can select, hold shift, select the whole shape, and then I can right click and say trace as a pattern. There we go. Okay, and then now I can sew this guy. So I guess I will click this guy and sew it to you. Oh, looks like my tabs got funky. Command B, it's better. Okay, and then I'm gonna pick the other side, click and click. Okay, does that look okay? I think that looks fine. I'm gonna zoom out. And then remember how we were practicing to superimpose? I want this to be a patch pocket. So I'm gonna select that guy, I'm gonna right click, and I'll say superimpose over. Okay, there we go. And now you have your patch pocket, I guess. And I can simulate. I'm gonna bring back just the regular fabric color and see what's going on here. Okay, it's so hard to see, right? So maybe we can change our fabric colors. I also noticed that there was a top stitch on this, I believe. Where did I see that? We can add more top stitching if we wanted. You might be asking, what are those orange lines? That's some kind of like seaming tape. You know, sometimes in swimsuits or even like athletic wear, they'll sew elastic inside the seam just to make it a little bit more sturdy. So that's what's happening here. So like if I click that line, you can check the property editor. Let's go ahead and scroll down. It's seam taping. They put in some taping there just to give it some more strength. So that's what that is. When you render, you wouldn't see it. Okay, but let's go over here to top stitching. Yeah, there's an overlock stitch. If you wanted to add more overlock stitching, you can do that too. It's totally optional. You don't have to. This is just like extra if you want to do it. Really, the point of this assignment is to let you guys play around with that 3D pen tool to kind of redesign this garment. But if you want to add more top stitching, you can go ahead and do that as well. So if you click this guy, maybe you do seam line. Oh, that's the pucker tool. Whoops. Let me go back here. Seam line top stitch. That way you only have to click the actual seam line. So, oops, let me go back. Start up here, click, and go down to the whole thing. And it's gonna apply it to both of those seams. So it'll be kind of like centered on the middle, which is neat. So feel free to play around with that. See, there it is. I see the little white guy right there. I'll go ahead and simulate. Not seeing it, right? I might have one of my views off. Let's see. Or maybe, you know what happened? I was on my default one. That's my problem. So let me go back to my arrow tool and it looks like it's selected. I'm going to click drag and drop the overlock one on it. Let's see if that helps. Maybe I'll click it as well just to make sure. There we go. Yes, I think that's working. I love when little mistakes happen because if it's happening to me, I'm sure it's probably happening to you as well. Okay, cool. Maybe if we want it on the side seam as well, make sure it's selected. Click. Okay, you're selected. I don't want to change your name. You're fine. And I'm going to go ahead and I like the seam one. That seems to be working for me. Click here and I'm going to go straight down. Or I'm going to attempt to. Maybe I went too far. There we go. Click you to you. We have to do it separate. Click you to you. Okay. There you go. A little bit of fun. You can change that as well too if you're like, I want it thicker. I want it to be a little bit more wide. You can definitely do that. Looks like the width right now, it's pretty small. Maybe you change it to like a quarter inch. Why not? Thread thickness, all kinds of good stuff. So kind of play around with that, sort of fun. Okay, well, anyways, you guys can do whatever you want. I'm hoping you can redesign the sweatshirt as well as the leggings with your pen tool. You're welcome to change the color of the fabrics and maybe just have fun with this tool, hopefully. So looking forward to seeing what you guys come up with. Let me know if you guys have any questions.